low pressure system will cross the Maritimes overnight, but clearing will occur tomorrow as mainly sunny weather dominates all three provinces. For all of New Brunswick and PEI, Sunday will bring sunny conditions, contrary to Nova Scotia, where cloud and showers will prevail. So the forecast for the Maritimes tonight, cloudy with showers, then clearing overnight with lows 12 to 15. Tomorrow, sunny for most regions with a few clouds in PEI and Nova Scotia, highs 18 to 23. And the outlook for Sunday, mainly sunny conditions for New Brunswick and PEI, but cloud and showers will dominate Nova Scotia, lows 10 to 12 and highs near 20. Harvey, is it diet time for William Perry?
I think it was diet time a long time ago. Finally, it just caught up with him. William the Refrigerator Perry is heading off to a rehab center for treatment for an eating disorder. We'll have details on that when we come back.
Pitch by Maria. Perfect brochettes by Provigo.
It's nice to know. It's ours. This summer, make it truly yours. New Brunswick. For the joy of it. Brunswick, make it yours. Give us a call.
Your Ford and New Holland dealer in the greater Miramichi area is Bremner Farms Limited, Center Napan. Specializing in both new and used, you can make your choice from skid steer loaders, a full line of farm equipment, lawn tractors, and all the attachments. Backed by factory-trained personnel, computerized parts department, on-location repair service. Come in, make your best deal now. Talk to Leon Bremner or one of his reliable staff at Bremner Farms Limited, Center Napan. Your Ford tractor and New Holland dealer for over 15 years. Your shopping and service center on the Miramichi, Chatham downtown. Dine in or take out at Pizza Delight, licensed dining, 254 Water Street. Featuring quality friendly service and their famous mouth-watering pizza, including thick and delicious deep dish pizza and their specialty Hawaiian pizza. Then try Pizza Delight's lasagna, spaghetti, donairs, or pizza tacos, just to name a few. Ask about their conference room. Pizza Delight, licensed dining, 254 Water Street, downtown Chatham. Nobody loves you better.
We agree.
Right.
$13,377 buys our new Grand Am from McDonald Pontiac.
Right. The stylish two-door.
Wrong. We're getting the practical but stylish four-door Grand Am for only $269.50 a month.
Wrong. The two-door.
But think about the plush interior.
Two-door's got it.
Think about the smooth ride.
Yep. Handles like a dream.
Well, what about options?
The two-door Grand Am SE from McDonald Pontiac has it all.
But what would be better for Mother?
A bus.
Funny, the Ford door.
It all starts at McDonald Pontiac Buick GMC, the going concern, 111 Beg Boulevard, Moncton.
Perfect pitch by Maria. Perfect brochettes by Provigo.
Good evening, everyone. In Major League Baseball, a full slate of action tonight. Boston leads Chicago 4-3 in the eighth inning. It's the Yankees up on Kansas City 6-5 in the fourth. Minnesota shutting out Baltimore 4-0 in the sixth. Texas leads Milwaukee 1-0 in the fourth. Toronto and Seattle are scoreless in the first. Cleveland's in California, Detroit at Oakland. Those are both late starts on the coast. Over in the National League, a doubleheader scheduled for the Big Apple. The Mets beat the Atlanta Braves 6-1 in the first game, and in the nightcap, it's the Mets leading again 2-0 in the fifth. Elsewhere, Chicago down San Diego 5-4 in 11 innings this afternoon. The Expos were beaten tonight 4-1 by Cincinnati. Los Angeles leads the Pittsburgh Pirates 3-1 in the seventh. It's Houston up on Philadelphia 4-0 in the fourth. St. Louis 2, San Francisco no score. They're currently in the fourth inning in St. Louis. Provincial softball championships get started this weekend in a pair of locations. This weekend, it's intermediate and senior slow pitch, with the intermediate tourney slated for St. John and the senior B event scheduled for Moncton. The big one, the provincial senior A softball championship, will be decided next weekend in Nelson Miramichi. William Perry of the Chicago Bears has always been a big man, but never as big as he is right now. And because of his increased girth, the team has ordered him to lose it or retire.
It was a cool, quiet day here in Platteville, the calm before the storm.
How you doing? Lovely to be here. Lovely to be here.
Jim McMahon was sporting a new haircut and the new TV, and Mike Ditka brought in his transportation. By evening, most of the veterans were here. The one signed veteran who did not show up was William Perry. And the reason became obvious just after 6 o'clock when the Bears released this statement. It says William Perry has elected to enter a program for treatment of an eating disorder. The Chicago Bears are in agreement with Perry that this is a medical matter, and the Bears will have no further comment at this time. Later on, however, Mike Ditka added this.
I think it's foolish to beat the thing up and belabor it. I mean, it stands as it's written, and we support it. All the way, really, because it's the best thing for him.
Ditka had given Perry an ultimatum after minicamp: get down from 370 to 320 or else no practice in Platteville.
I talked to William about, I guess it would have been about 2 weeks ago. In person, I weighed him, and at that point, I weighed him at about 258. And I knew he couldn't, there would be no way, and I talked to him at length about the fact that it would be hard to take off the weight.
In Platteville, Rich King for Channel 2 Sports.
Another CFL game on tap tonight. The Calgary Stampeders in British Columbia to meet the Lions. There's no scoring in that one yet. It's a late start on the West Coast. The St. John Loyalist Days soccer tournament is underway tonight in the Port City. 19 teams from around New Brunswick, as well as from Maine and Nova Scotia, are in town for the boys and girls event. The tournament wraps up on Sunday. Sport fishermen from around the world are always dreaming of that trophy catch, whether it be a bass, marlin, lake trout, pickerel, or Atlantic salmon. And later this month on the Kennebecasis River just east of St. John, fishermen will have a chance to catch the big one. It's the first annual Great Sturgeon Hunt, and organizer Mike Donovan explained to CHSJ's Paul Martin just how the event came about.
Well, Paul originally started off Aberdeen Motors. The Suzuki deal on Rossy Avenue wanted a whole little fishing derby. And we were going to have a father-son deal, but we couldn't find anywhere in the St. John area that there's a lot of fish, except right here. But they're big fish. So rather than a father-son deal, it's progressed into quite a little event. There are huge sturgeon out here. In fact, there are some fish that are bigger than this boat, believe it or not. We've had reports of fish up to 20 feet long. Mind you, they're scarce. The average sturgeon out here would run 3 to 4 feet in length. It's not uncommon to catch them 6 and 7 feet long. That's going to get the attention of a lot of fishermen.
And not only will fishermen have a chance to win money and prizes, but they might also get their names in the Book of World Records.
Yes, well, we're fortunate. I sent away to Florida to the world record people, and I get a copy of the record book. And there must be, I'm going to guess, 2,000 different species of fish that are entered in the book. But somehow nobody's ever entered a short-nosed sturgeon. And I contacted other people in Florida. They did some research. They found out that, in fact, we do have huge short-nosed sturgeon up here, and they're plentiful. And on that day, the Canadian representative, Mr. Bill Waite, is going to be here. And the biggest short-nosed sturgeon caught that day is going to go in the record book as a new world's record.
But when it boils right down to it, the money, the prizes, the records, they don't mean a whole lot to Mike Donovan. He's happiest when he's just catching fish.
Well, my heart starts to pound, like a little weak in the knees. And it's a lot of fun to have that rod in your hand and it just throbbing away. We throw back probably 90% of our fish. We keep a few brook trout, but the rest of our fish we pretty well put back. But it's some fun to be holding onto a rod and it just throbbing.
So is there any place in the world you'd rather be than out in your boat fishing?
No, that's where I am almost every day that I'm off. I'm out fishing. Any kind of fish I can find.
The Great Sturgeon Hunt takes place on Sunday, July 31st, and entries are limited to 250. To enter, you can contact Mike Donovan at 849-2335. That's 849-2335. Proceeds from the event go to the Children's Wish Foundation. And the Edmonton Oilers have swapped left wingers with Washington. Jeff Courtnell is Washington-bound in exchange for Greg Adams. Courtnell, of course, split last season between Boston and Edmonton. He had 36 goals and 66 points in 74 games. Adams has 153 points through his NHL career, which has spanned five seasons with Washington. He also has almost 700 penalty minutes. And that's my look at sports. Steve?
Have you ever caught a sturgeon, Harvey?
Never have, and they're so ugly I'm not sure I'd ever want to.
But, a place in the Guinness Book of World Records would be kind of nice.
Certainly would. Boy, it'd be nice to have a 14 or 15 foot sturgeon from out there, wouldn't it?
Maybe we should go out.
I think maybe we should.
Okay. No,
we'll say that now.
That's about wraps it up, I guess, for this week. So we hope you have a terrific weekend, and we'll see you again on Monday.
Good night.
Week, Crime Stoppers needs your help in solving the 60-year-old attempted murder of a former member of the Shediac Town Police, Constable Clarence Bork.
It was approximately 1:30 a.m., June 2nd, 1981. Constable Bork was working the last part of a double shift. He explained to investigators that he was driving east on East Main Street in Shediac near the entrance to the LJR High School. He noticed a man walking east, drove by him, and felt that this man may have been intoxicated. Constable Book drove into the entrance of the LJR High School, turned his vehicle, and drove back towards East Main Street. He stopped his vehicle at the intersection and got out to check the man on the street. Constable Book advised that he and this man had a brief conversation. Then Constable Book placed him under arrest, and together they walked to the parked police car. At the police car, Constable Book told investigators that as he was about to have the man get into the police car, a struggle broke out. The suspect then ran east on Main Street and turned into the private driveway of Mr. Cedric Legier. Constable Bork advised that he gave chase and caught his suspect in the field between the Leger home and the LJR school. Here, they struggled and the suspect got a hold of Constable Bork's police revolver and shot Constable Bork. The suspect ran to the police car, got in, and drove east. As he left the scene, he struck a utility pole on the side of the road. Police car and Constable Bork's revolver were later recovered in the water off of Cap Bime near Shediac. Constable Bork, wounded three times, managed to call his dispatcher. He advised the dispatcher of his condition and help was immediately sent to him. Crime Stoppers will pay a minimum $1,000 this week for information that leads to the arrest of the person responsible for the attempt on former Constable Bork's life. If you have any information concerning this case or any other serious crimes in New Brunswick, call Crime Stoppers at 1-800-222-TIPS. That's 1-800-222-8477. And remember, you do not have to reveal your identity, and should your tip lead to an arrest, you qualify for an award. Call now.
When Toyota was judged the winner of